Dear students, now see the boy French, he's feeling upset and for his teacher that he's leaving the school after 40 years. And now we further move. While I was thinking all this, I heard my name called and it was my turn to recite what would I have. And now see, as he was thinking, everything was moving inside his mind, inside his brain, and he was sitting. Suddenly the teacher, he called him and asked him to recite the participles. And he felt, he tried, but he was... not able to recite, and he felt ashamed and stood with his head down. That is, he did not have the courage to look at his master. He was feeling so ashamed, so embarrassed he was. So now I heard M. Hamel say to me, "I won't scold you, little friends. You must feel bad enough. See how it is. Every day we have said to ourselves, 'Bah, I have plenty of time and I'll learn till tomorrow. Now those fellows out there have the right to say to you, how is it you pretend to be Frenchmen and yet you can neither speak nor write your own language? But you are not the worst poor little French. We have all great deal to reproach ourselves with.'" Now see, the boy is standing, M. Hamel, he looks at his student and he says that he should not feel embarrassed for it. He should not be ashamed. But see, now what would be the result of it? The German people, they will come and they will remark you, they will tell you that you pretend to be French people, you show that you are French. But still, you see, you are not able to speak and write the French language. Such a shameful it is. And he says, "You are not to be blamed for it. We all are there who are to be blamed. It is," first he says, "it is your parents, that is your parents, who are first to be blamed, because," what he says in this paragraph, "your parents were not anxious enough to have you learn. They preferred to put you to work on a farm or at the mill so as to have a little more money. And I have been to blame also. Have I often not sent you to water my flowers instead of learning your lessons? And when I wanted to go fishing, did I not just give you holidays?" And now he says, we all are responsible for it. First is your parents, he says, your parents who wants that you should not go to school. Instead of it, you should go for working in the farms as well as in the mills so that they could earn some money for you could earn some money for them. And further he says that M. Hamel is also responsible for it. How is he responsible? Because whenever he wanted, he had sent them to water the plants. And even sometimes on a sunny days, whenever he wanted the children's, whenever he wanted to go fishing, he used to give children the holidays. And this is how he wasted his time as well as the time of the children also, by giving them holidays and by sending them to water his plants. Whereas the parents, they doesn't give any attention to the studies. They wanted that they should work in the farm as well as in the mill so that they could have more earning from them. Then from one thing to another, M. Hamel went on to talk to the French language, saying that it was the most beautiful language in the world, and the clearest and the most logical, and we must guard it among us and never forget it, because when a people are enslaved, language in the world, the clearest, the most logical, and we must guard it among us. Never forget it, because when people are enslaved, as long as they hold fast to their language, it is as if they had the key to their prison. And now see these last few lines, it's the most significant lines they are, that is, I'll be reading these lines once again for you, that is, we must guard it. The clearest and most logical language is French language, and that we must guard it among us and never forget it, because when the people are enslaved, as long as they hold fast to their language, it is as if they had the key to their prison. Then he opened the grammar and read us our lesson. I was amazed to see how well understood it. And now he wrote the importance of this language so far. As far as we are enclosed with this language, we will be having a key to open the freedom. That is, when a people are enslaved, as long as they hold fast to their language, it is as if they had the key to the prison. Language is the tool to fight against the dominance. That is, to fight for the freedom. It is only the language which teaches us to how to get the freedom. And the prose writer, that is the narrator here, French, is describing us the importance of this language. And the moment he emphasized on the importance of a French language, the boy was more enthusiastic now to learn. I was amazed to see how well I understood all he said. Seemed so easy, I think, to that. Now the reason behind here is, the boy, he says, he felt very happy, he felt very confident, and he was he was able to understand each and everything very clearly, because he was attentive, and the respect that now he has for this language, the love that has suddenly come to him for this language. I'd never listened so carefully, and he was careful in listening to the listening what the teacher is teaching. That is, carefulness has brought everything clear to his mind. I had never listened so carefully, and that he had never explained everything with so much patience. It seemed almost as if the poor man wanted to give us all he knew before going away, and to put it all into our heads at one stroke. And now he says that it was not only the boy who was carefully listening, but the teacher M. Hamel was also making the thing so easy for them that it looks, the boy says, that he wanted to give everything. He wants everything to give in a one go only, and that is why he says it was, that is, the boy was so he was able to understand each and everything very clearly. After the grammar, we had a lesson in writing today. That day M. Hamel had new copies for us, written beautiful round hand, France, Elias. They looked like little flags floating everywhere in the schoolroom, hung from the rod at the top of our desk. You ought to have seen how everyone set to work and how quiet it was. The only sound was the scratching of the pens over the paper. Once the beetles flew in, but nobody paid any attention to them, and not even the littlest one, who worked right to the tracing their fish hooks as if that was a French too. On the roof, the pigeon cooed very low, and I thought to myself, will they make them to cook That is, will they make them to sing in German, even the pigeons? Now see this paragraph, it describes the few things, the few important things. The teacher who was teaching the French now gave them the notebooks he has brought with them, and these notebooks, it has written France lies on them, and the boy feels as if these flags, they are the feels the these written words as a flag which floats on the in the class. And he says the class was so quiet, it was so quiet that is they cannot even hear anything. It was so quietness was there that even the pen that scratched that could be heard, that is, everybody was so busy in writing all these things. Now see, students, sometimes insect or anything enters your class, you start making so much of noise. Now see, the beetle even, which was large in size, it enter their class, but still nobody moved. Everybody was sitting and they were busy in writing and learning as if it was there. That is, they were enjoying reading in the class. Then in last two lines they have given, the boy, he looks up and he saw a pigeon who was cooking over there, and he says, he think for himself, will they make them sing in Germany, even the pigeons? They means the German people, those who has now dominance over these French allies, and they say, will they be able to make these people to sing in German? And with this he starts thinking, could they do this thing? And then they stop.